Good evening, good evening, good evening. That all the people of God said, amen, amen, and amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, enter to his gate with thanksgiving. Amen. Evangelist on with us this evening. Thanks, love, always for getting the music. Amen. Amen. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. And we thank you, Lord, for sending the storm and the rain and the wind around. Yes, we had our share of storm this year, but Lord, you held back justice and gave us your mercy. And for that, we said thank you, thank you, thank you. I lift mine eyes to the hill, from which cometh my help. Oh, my help come from above. Brenda Dunlap, how are you doing? To all our friends, to all our family, we said to God be the glory. Brother George, God bless you. Amen. George Goodman, Chief Dishman, and Clara, God bless you. Christy Dunn with us this evening. Amen. The storm is passing over. Evelyn William Kitchen Ruff, Pee Wee out of St. Louis, God bless you. Amen. Brenda from Chicago. All right. Brother Jenkins, how you doing this morning? Thank you so much for tuning in with us. Amen. Amen. How has God blessed you? Kiana's tuned in with us this evening. Amen. Amen. Lord, 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 you sure been blessing us. Not just one time, but over and over and over again. You just keep on blessing us. Travel grace and mercy for all those that are on the road. Amen, amen. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? Sister Dr. Callie, how you doing? Amen, amen. Don't forget, share this message with your friends, share it with your family, and share it with your network. Amen, amen. Oh, what a wonderful God we serve. What an awesome God we serve that look beyond all our faults and supply our need and bless us in spite of ourselves, in spite of us coming short of the glory. Michelle Conway, God bless you. Amen. If God has blessed you, go ahead and say amen and praise his holy and righteous name. One thing I found out, because he's worthy to be praised. Yes, he's worth of all praise, all honor, and all glory. Amen. Didn't know what we're going to be able to broadcast this evening because the storm was raging. But when the storms of life are raging, God said he'd stand by you. Katrina down on the Gulf Coast, God bless you. Missed all the fun and activities up here. Amen, amen. All right, let's see what kind of music Evangelist got for us this evening. Amen. All right, this is Marvin Sapp. Thank you for it all. Marvin Sapp, Pastor Marvin Sapp, thank you for it all. And yes, we got to thank God. He didn't have to do it, but he did. Sound check, Brenda, how we coming through? I thank you for it all. My ups and good, bad, ugly, great and small. We got to thank him for it all. What have you got to thank for? I'm so grateful that I'm still standing tall. Still standing. Amen. And I thank you for it all. Yes, yeah, we had to cry sometime. Oh, yeah. But we thank you for the tears. Yes, yes, yes. Good thank you, Brenda. Loud and clear. All right. Lima Charlie. Oh, yeah. Do you thank God for your up? Thank God for your down, for everything, big and small. Yes, he brought us through. I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for it all. Not just part of it, but thank you for it all. Yes, man. Thank you, Lord, for letting the storm pass over. The songwriter said the storm is passing over. Oh, man, I thank you for it all. Thank you for the tears. How many of you had to cry sometime? Yeah. But God helped you through the pain, through the trouble, the heartache, and the pain. All right. God, 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 such a good God, God, such an awesome God, such a mighty God. Look beyond all our fault and found our need. Amen. Thank you for it. All right. How has God blessed you? Amen. Brandon's on with us this evening. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for it all. Because of you, Lord, we are what we are. Amen. Thank you for it all, Lord. For my ups, for my downs, and turnarounds. Amen. 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 Any prayer requests? Any prayer requests? Go ahead, type those prayer requests in the comment box. Amen. Yeah, for those that are on the road traveling grace and mercy, we thank you for. Amen. All right. Lord, have mercy on our soul. We got so much to be thankful for. And we just don't thank you enough. Gotta say thank you. Lord, before we ask you for anything, we thank you for everything. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. All right, kind of say, woke up to see another day. Found the family doing good. All right. All right, yeah, you got something to be thankful for. I'd have made a prayer for her niece, Barbara, dying, and her family, friends, and neighbors always, them children and grandchildren. Amen. Got you, Mother Jenkins. Thank you, thank you, thank you for my health, for my strength. I want to see you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Had to count the family to your list. Evangeline, she's not feeling well. And me for my upcoming surgery. Amen. Good evening. All right, any special prayer request? Type them in the comment box. I thank you for the good, bad, ugly, great and small. Thank you, Lord. Oh, yeah. I thank you for it all. Yes, yes, yeah. We had to cry sometime. Oh, yeah. I thank you for my tears. We still here, still standing. Oh, yeah. Are we going to back this up and then go through our evening prayer? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Marvin said, I thank you for it all. Amen. Our prayer list, the family of Pastor J.C. Smith, he passed this week. Let's pray for the Smith family. Pastor Rob Lanier, Pastor Roman Fullerlove, Reverend Kenneth Watson, Pastor Joe Willie Anderson, Reverend Green Oliver, Deacon Adam Bond, Deacon Bob Bond, Norman Westbrook, Ernestine Webb, Rosemary Taylor, Mary Dunn, Diane Jackson, Roy Jackson, Barbara Dye, Brother Clyde Jenkins, glad he's doing well, Anthony Harris, Terry Smith, Weston Blue, Brianna Newcrate, Major Conway, Leonard Conway, all right, Melvin Conway, the mothers, Lori Hubbard, Kat Smith, Clara Dispin, Dar Lara, Ida Mae Jenkins, the people of Ukraine, and Cat Milton and Bobby at the Traveling Grace and Mercy, they come back from departing the Godfather into rest. Amen. And to you, our Father, children, praying for our children, praying mightily for them and the people of Ukraine. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank and praise you for life. We thank and praise you for health, and we thank you, praise you for strength. We got so much to be thankful for. We realize this evening, Master, that we just don't thank you enough. So this evening, Master, before we ask you for anything, we pause and thank you for everything. And you, we live, move, and have our being, lifting you up, the author and the finish of our faith, Lord God. Thank you, Frey, for letting the storm pass over, enable us to keep our golden moment intact and rolling on. We just thank you, Lord God, for the Clark. Bless them, Junior, and his family, all that he holds dear, Mother Clark. Lord, 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 come down with mercy. Lord, 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 come down with grace. Lord, you saw the prayer list is on, long, long. And those that left off, the thing we fail not to mention, Lord, please fail not to grant. Grant it, dear Lord. Grant it, grant it, grant it, dear Lord. We know it's your will that none should perish. So we come with head bowed down and heart lifting up, praying, Lord God, for the McNeil family lost of their pastor, Pastor Smith, and praying for the new pastor, Lord God, Brother Proud. Just lift them up, Lord God. Lord, come now with mercy. Come now with grace. Touch, Lord God. Heal and restore. We trying to figure it out, Lord. You already work it out. We turn it over to you, Lord. You work it out. Praying for all those, Lord God, within the sound of our voice, that you bless them in a very special manner. Now, Lord, give a word on how for these thy people, these thy children, Lord, that will strengthen them, that will prop us up when we're sagging. Lord God, touch your healing, you're sick. Touch your evangelist, Lord God, you're not feeling well. Touch all those on our weak for us. Heal, Lord God. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen, amen. Junior Clark, God bless you, bless you, bless you. Just want to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord. You've been so good. Now, Lord, touch. Now, Lord, heal. Sister Lois Whalen, God bless you. Amen and amen. That was Pastor Marvin Sepp. Thank you for it all. Hey. I just want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. You've been so good, so good, so good. All right, as we continue with our series about the women of the Bible. Amen. Amen. Our scripture this evening coming out of John chapter 4. John chapter 4. And let's pick up and read a few verses. It's the whole fourth chapter, but we're not going to read the whole fourth chapter. We're going to start at verse number 3. He being Jesus, left Judea and departed again into Galilee, and he must need go through Samaria. Then come he to the city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and was about the 6th hour, 12 o'clock noon. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus said to her, give me to drink. Amen. Give me to drink. Amen. Just for a little while this evening, the time, this hour, I want to preach from this subject. A confused woman. A confused woman. As I said, we continue our series. We're going to look at the woman at the well and this unnamed woman in her dialogue with Jesus. The woman at the well. My, my, my. All right. This was a confused woman. The woman at the well was confused. All right. Many people today, like we men also included, we know we confused. Like that woman at the well. She was confused about several things. But when she met Jesus, Sister Dot, she wasn't confused anymore, Bob. Pee-wee, when she come in contact with Jesus, Lord, she wasn't confused anymore. Well, what is confusion? If you're confused, it's a feeling of awe. It's a feeling or exhibiting or showing an inability to understand. And bewildered, baffled, perplexed, stumped, puzzled, mixed up, or out to lunch. All those mean we're confused. And with everything that's going on in the world today, there's so many confused people. Men trying to be women, they're confused. Women trying to be men, they are confused. My. Samaria was between Galilee in the north and Judea in the south, Judea and Jerusalem in the south. The shortest way for the Jewish people to go north from Jerusalem or south or from Galilee was to travel through Samaria. Now, to avoid the Samaritan completely, the Jews avoided the Samaritan completely. All right. They disregard efficiency in the shortest route, and they travel east across the Jordan River through Perea, and then they went north. They was avoiding Samaria because they had a bad blood with the Samaritan, and they considered the Samaritan to be unclean. So they went out of their way, Lord God, to get to Galilee from Judea and Jerusalem. This is just like we are in Robinsonville and going through Tunica. Well, we got to go through Hollywood, but instead of that, we go out to Banks, go down number 3 all the way to Dundee, and then come back up. Just so. And this the route that the Jews took in order to avoid Samaria. All right. But Jesus, all right, said he had to go through Samaria. Now, this story starts with, like I said, Jesus needed to make a trip to Galilee. Verse 4 tells us that Jesus must need go through Samaria. In other words, he had to go. It was necessary that he go through Samaria. He had to go through it. Now, we know now that he had to have a conversation with a confused woman at the well in Sychar. After a long, tiring journey, they came. Jesus and the disciples came to the town of Sychar. It was about 12 o'clock noon. Jesus sat down at the well outside of town, and the disciples went into town to buy meat, to buy food. Now let's look at the interaction that occurred between Jesus and the woman at the well. Now keep in mind that this was a confused woman. All right. Now we're talking about women, men. We know you're confused, but you please listen in also. She came to the well at 12 o'clock noon in the heat of the day. Now we know from literature that most women during that time period came to the water hole, came to the well in the morning or in the late afternoon while it was still cool. No one came to the well at noontime in the heat of the day. Yeah, but you know why this lady came to the well, all right, in the heat of the day. Well, she probably wasn't getting along with the rest of the women in the town. Now, history has painted a bad picture of this woman. Maybe she would deserve it, maybe not. Maybe she had had a rough time in life and was shown by the women. Regardless of her background, Jesus was there to save our soul. And regardless of our background, and regardless of the rough time that we have had in life, it's good to know that Jesus is there and he will save our soul. And it started out, Jesus asked the woman from Samaria for a drink of water. This is where she began to show her confusion. All right. First thing, we're going to look at several things that she was confused about. Her lineage, race, living water. She was confused about loftiness and greatness. She was confused about that liquid H2O water. She was confused about living arrangement. She was confused about laudation, which means to praise. She was confused about the Lord as Messiah. And finally, she had to leave her water pot. My. Her lineage and race. Verse 9 tells us this woman was confused about race and her heritage. How is it? Because when Jesus asked her for a drink of water, she said, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask me, a woman, which am from Samaria, for a drink? You got to understand that the Jews had no dealing with the Samaria. It was a race thing. All right? The Jews had no dealing with the Gentile or the Samaritan. All right? Whites have no dealing with blacks. Blacks have no dealing with white. Brown have no dealing with red, or red have no dealing with yellow. All right? One race have no dealing with the other race. One race want to destroy the other race. And it's funny, we all made by God, and we made from the dust of the ground. Wasn't Martin Luther King Jr. said that we must live together as brothers, or we will perish as fools? My. Well, Martin King, if you were still around, you'd see that we were perishing like fools. All right. So this woman was confused about race. My. She was confused about her culture, and she was confused about her lineage. Not only was this woman confused about her lineage and race, she was confused about living water. We find that in verse 10 and 11. And Jesus answers her, if you knew the gift of God, and if you knew who it was that said to you, that asked you for a drink of water, you would, instead of me asking you, you would have asked him for some water, and he would give you that living water. My. Yeah, she was confused about that living water. I know she was confused. She said, sir, Jesus, you don't have anything to draw with, and the well is deep. Where did you get that living water? I don't see you with anything. So where did you get water? Now, we understand now that we have nothing to draw with. My. The well is deep. And the well is symbolic of the Spirit of God and the water. All right. It's God's blessing. There's no physical bucket that we can draw living water. All right. The bucket is our heart. And as Romans 10:10 said, we got to believe in our heart and we got to confess with our mouth. This woman was confused about the living water. She thought Jesus was talking about drinking water. And he was talking about the Holy Spirit, which he called the living water. So many of us are confused about the living water, confused about the Holy Spirit. Well, I'm here to tell you, the Holy Spirit will convict you. The Holy Spirit will convert you. And we got to believe in our heart and confess with our mouth. And this is our drawing call. She thought he was talking about drinking water, and he's talking about the Holy Spirit. Come here, John, and witness for me. John said in chapter 7, verse 37, in the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried and said, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of water, living water. But he was speaking about the Holy Spirit. If you're thirsty, come unto Jesus. Yeah, this woman was confused about water. And Jesus talking about the Holy Ghost. And she didn't see a bucket. She didn't see Jesus had nothing to draw with. But what she didn't know, that Jesus was water in dry places. Yeah, she was confused about her lineage and race. She was confused about living water. This woman was confused. She was confused about loftiness and greatness. My. We find this in verse number 12, where she asked Jesus, "Art thou greater than our father Jacob?" You see, they called the well Jacob well, because Jacob had dug the well a long, long, long time ago. He gave him that well and he drank there, his children and his animal. Yeah, she asked him, was he greater than Jacob? She was confused about greatness. We too are confused about greatness. We look at greatness in our position. We look at greatness in our possession. And we look at greatness in our places. Instead of looking at greatness in our position, our belief in God. Matthew recorded in chapter 20, verse 26, when the disciple was arguing about who would be greatest in the kingdom, Jesus said, whosoever want to be greatest among you, you must also be your servant. So if you want to be great, you've got to be a servant of the Most High God. Yeah, remember the word minister mean to serve. You got to minister to the people. You got to serve the people and meet their need. This woman was confused about loftiness and greatness. My. She was confused about a lot of things. Not only was she confused about the living water, she was confused about the liquid H2O. She was confused about the plain water. This woman was confused about water. Jesus answered in verse 13 and 14. He said to this confused woman, "Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give them shall never thirst." My. Do you want to not thirst anymore? And the water that I shall give him shall be a well, a water springing in eternal life. My. Look at Jesus tell the woman. He had told her about the living water. Now he gonna tell her about the plain H2O, about the plain woman. This woman was confused. He told her he would give her that living water. He would give her the water and she never thirst again. Jesus said, "If you're thirsty, come unto me and I will give you drink." He water in dry places. Understand this, Jesus didn't want no water. He couldn't have want water because he water in dry places, just like he wasn't hungry because he bred in a starving land. Jesus, well, the woman said, "Sir, give me that water that I thirst not, neither come here to draw any more." Jesus was talking about the healing power, the guiding power of the Holy Spirit. And the woman thought he was talking about water. You see, she didn't want to come to the well in the heat of the day. She couldn't come in the morning with the other women. She couldn't come in the evening time when it was cool. She had to come in the heat of the day because of her behavior. This woman was confused about water. My. And so many of us are confused about drinking water. Jesus trying to give us that living water that flow from Emmanuel's well, and we don't want to come to the well. We want the benefit of the water, but we don't want to have the Savior in our life. We want the water, but we don't have anything to draw with. You can't draw this water with a bucket. You can't draw this water with a pail. You got to draw this water with your heart. This woman was confused. And this woman was confused about a lot of stuff. She was confused about her living arrangement. Simply put, she was confused about men. It recorded in verse 16. When he asked him for the water, Jesus said, I tell you what, go call your husband and come back. The woman answered and said, 17, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, you have said well, I have no husband. Understand this. She didn't know she was talking to the all-seeing eye. Jesus knew everything. Jesus saw everything. What's done in the dark shall surely be brought to light. So Jesus said to the woman, you've had five husbands, and now you're working on number six. The one that you have right now is not thy husband. You told the truth that time, sister. Many of us are confused about living arrangement. We want to put the cart before the horse in our relationship. We want to live together. We want to shack together. We want to have children before we get married. We putting the cart before the horse. But that's all right. Turn it over to Jesus. Repent, and he'll make everything all right. You got to get the relationship right. This woman was confused about relationship. Many of us are confused about relationship. We got to have the relationship with God before we can have the right relationship with man or with woman. Don't be confused. My. God is an awesome God. This woman was confused. This woman was confused about laudation, that the root word being laud mean to praise. Simply put, this woman was confused about worship place. We find in verse 19 and 20, the woman said, trying to change the subject, I perceive that thou art a prophet. My, yeah, our father worshiped in this mountain, Mount Gerizim. And you said that in Jerusalem is the place that men ought to worship. I'm confused. So many of us are confused about the worship place. We must understand that it's not the place that we worship, but it's the individual who we worship. Jesus explained to this woman how to worship God. Yeah, we confused about worship. You said we ought to worship as Baptist worship. Others said we got to worship like the Methodist or the Catholic or the Kojic. But Jesus explained how we ought to worship in the 24th verse. What he told a woman when she said, I'm confused about the place to worship. Jesus said, don't be confused about the place. The place don't matter. It's the man that you worship. 24 said, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Don't worry about the place you worship. You better worship. You better worry about the how you worship. You got to worship God in spirit and in truth. Not like the Baptist, not like the Methodist, not like any other denomination. In spirit and in truth. It is true that God is a spirit. Worship him in spirit. It is true that he looked beyond all our faults and found our need. got to worship him in truth and in spirit. This woman was confused about worship. This woman was confused about the Lord as the Messiah. Yeah, she was confused, Sister Home, about the Messiah. This woman said, verse 25, I know that when the Messiah comes, and he is called the Christ, when he comes, he gonna tell her everything. Jesus said, I'm that speaking to you. I am the Messiah. I am the Alpha and Omega. I am the first. I am the last. I am the beginning and the end. I'm bread in a starving land. And since we at this well, I'm water in dry places. He that thirsts, come and drink free. Well, when not only was this woman confused, the disciples was confused when they got back and saw Jesus talking to the woman. They didn't understand he was saving her soul. And the woman, yeah, after she met Jesus, after she got straight about this water, this woman left her water pot. She threw her water pot away. 28 said, a woman left her water pot and went into the city and said to the men, come see a man which told me everything that I ever did. Is not this the Christ? And then they came out of the city to meet him. Yeah, she threw away her water pot because she wasn't confused anymore. The water pot symbolized her old way of life. Yeah, she threw her water pot. Come here, Paul, and witness for me. He said, in Christ Jesus, I'm a new creation. Behold, all things are passed away, and all things are made new. She left her water pot. Matter of fact, she threw it away. I'm throwing away my old life. I'm throwing away all the things that I used to do. I'm throwing away lying. I'm throwing away backstabbing. I'm throwing away backbiting. I'm throwing away cheating. I'm throwing away shacking up with men. I'm throwing away not doing things according to God's will. And I'm coming under God. She said, it was raining in my life, but now the storm has passed over and I can see clearly. She went and evangelized the town, and they came out to see Jesus, and they told this woman, we came because you said so, but now we here for ourselves. This woman that had had five husbands, this woman, this confused woman that didn't have a husband right now, but was shacking up. But when she met Jesus, she wasn't confused anymore. She said, I'm on the right road now. I'm going after Jesus. I got to tell everybody. And she picked up a Williams song. I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody that can save anybody. He saved her soul right there at the water well. He saved her soul after he told her about herself. Yeah, she was confused about Jesus, but she wasn't confused about race anymore. After she met Jesus, she understand that whosoever will, let him come. She wasn't confused about water, because he was water in dry places. She wasn't confused about greatness. She said, Jesus, the great Alpha and Omega. She wasn't confused about water. She realized that she had to be dipped in the water. She had to be baptized. She realized that she needed that cooling water from Grandma Well. She wasn't confused about her living arrangement. She made it right. She wasn't confused about the worship place. She realized that God was a spirit. He had to be worshiped, not in place, but in spirit and in truth. She wasn't confused about the Messiah. She realized that Jesus was the Messiah, and she left her water pot. She realized that Jesus come down to 40 and two generations, made the lame to walk, made the dumb to talk. She realized they went to a hill called Calvary, where they hung him high, where they stretched him wide. He hung his head, and for me, he died. He died. He died. The sun refused to shine. The moon fell in blood. The lightning struck. The thunder roared, the earth rocked and reeled like a drunken man. They took him down, put him in the grave, but the grave couldn't hold him. Early, 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 the third day, he got up with all power in his hand. He caught the cloudy escalator, and he went on home. But one day, he's coming back. For his church, without spot or without rancor. He's coming back. Amen. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Praise God. Amen. You don't know Bacardi. Zaccardi Cortez. You don't know.
You don't know.
You don't know when. Don't know what you've been through. We don't know what all this woman been through. She's been through a lot. She was confused. But when she met Jesus, she wasn't confused anymore. We were confused. But when we met Jesus, we shouldn't have been confused anymore. He brought her through a lot. Through hard times. Through good times. He brought her through. You don't know what he brought me through. You can't tell my story, and I can't tell your story. So tell your story, what he done for you and what he brought you through. My, my, my. And you got to thank him. Pastor South said, thank him for it all. Try him. You don't know. Waiting on God. You got to hold on. We offer you Christ, the Son, the living God. You don't know what we had to endure. Christ, the Son of the living God, give your heart to God. And give your hand to the man of God, woman of God. All right. Yes, Bob, not black power, all power. We don't know what we've been through, Evangel. We've been through a lot, and we're still going through. But turn it over to God. He works it out. Trouble in my way, you had to cry sometimes. Amen. We offer you Christ, the Son, the living God. We don't know what you've been through, Lord. Pee-wee, Dot, Christy, Karen, Trina, Brandon. We don't know what everybody's been through. We just know we've been through something. But we know that God brought it through us, not just one time, but over and over and over again, he brought it through. And we don't know. You got a story to tell. Tell your story. How God blessed you. How he looked for you and your folks. We saw your knees. You don't know, Brother John. Chief, you don't know. Claire, you don't know what other folks going through. You just know what you've been through and how he delivered you. Tell your story. How God bless you. You don't know. Don't know. You can't know. You might know what they're going through, but you don't know how they feel. The only person you know is you. Tell your story. Don't know.
You don't know. Tell somebody you just don't know.
You just don't know. Thank you, Jesus.
Don't know. Don't know. Don't just don't know.
precious Lord, we thank and praise you for life and strength. Lord, I realize I'm a wretch undone. I've gone contrary to your will. The things you told me not to do, I went ahead and did. And the things I was supposed to do, I left undone. Simply put, Lord, I was confused. Lord, I was confused about right. I was confused about wrong. I was confused about truth. I was confused about the Christ. We were confused about so many things. But thank you, Lord, that one day we met you and you healed our soul and we're not confused anymore. Now bless us and keep us. I confess. I repent. I acknowledge you as Lord and Savior. I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth that thou art the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Bless us and keep us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We're going to close out with "That You Don't Know" in a moment. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. Is our prayer for you. Amen. Amen. Announcement. Special prayer for the family of Pastor J.C. Smith and his home going McNeil out on Crenshaw Road. Amen. All right. Come worship with us this second Sunday. Second Sunday in April, we will be at the Commerce 11 o'clock service. We will be worshiping with the Commerce Boulevard Christian Church, Pastor Evan Hubbard. I will be bringing the message. All right. Second Sunday in April, we will be at Commerce Boulevard. Amen. Come worship with us then. All right. Now, the New Corinth Church family, we will be celebrating Easter on that Saturday, April 16, on the church ground. Refreshment, egg hunts, and things for the children. And then that Sunday, we will have our Easter program, the children's speeches, and the morning service. Amen. For those that are traveling, Mother Kat, Hayes Smith, as you and Bobby went to lay to rest their Godfather. Amen. Let us continue to pray for this world, the war in Ukraine, war and rumors of war. Let's be safe. All right. The virus is still here. Let's continue to pray for our children. Let's pray for their safety. Let's pray for their education, but mostly for their salvation. Amen. God bless you. God keeps you. Is our prayer for you. You don't know. Bottled up inside. All right. Share this message with your friend, family, and everyone. Thank God that Kat and Bobby Neal made it back home. God bless you. Amen. Niece Brenda, God bless you. Lois Whalen, God bless you. Barb Hibbler, Junior Clark, God bless you. Pee Wee, God bless you. Brenda, Chief, Claire, George, Karen, Krista, Trina, Brandon, Kiana, God bless you. You don't know. Nancy, home, God bless you. Amen. God is good all the time. You don't know. We thank you so much for your financial contribution to this church and to this ministry. It's much needed and much appreciated. Go ahead, post the cash app. God bless you. Cash app, New Corinth Tunica. God bless you. God keeps you. Is our prayer for you. Remember, we all were confused. And we may still get confused sometimes. But I'm here to tell you, once you meet Jesus, then we ain't confused anymore. Amen. Don't forget, share this. Share with your friend. Share with your family. And share with your network. You don't know. Amen. God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank and praise you for life. We thank and praise you for health, and we thank and praise you for strength. We got so much to be thankful for. Continue praying for Sister Diane, the family of Pastor Smith, that you lift them up. Touch her spirit, Lord God, to heal her body. We come now with mercy, grace. Lord God, we thank you for what eyes are seen. We thank you for what ears are heard, but mostly we thank you for what heart felt as you opened up the windows of heaven and poured us out a blessing. Now, may the love of God, the grace of our Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ, the sweet communion of Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide each other now, henceforth, and forevermore. The people of God said, amen, amen. God bless you. God keeps you. Is our prayer for you. Just don't know. Just don't know. Don't know, don't know, don't know. Just don't know it. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you Sunday around 11 o'clock. I have another message from on high. All right, this first Sunday, so we'll be doing communion. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful evening. Amen. Amen.